Buganda Road Chief Magistrate Court attributed former Rubaga Deputy Resident City Commissioner Herbert Anderson Borora's 9-day incarceration to his defense team failing to apply for bail immediately after he was remanded. In his judgment today, Chief Magistrate Ronald Kaizi ruled that the charge sheet is clear and that all the elements that implicate Borora are vivid. The judge, however, in the interest of fairness, asked the prosecution to make some amendments, which they complied to.
Section 28 of the Computer Misuse Act states, a person shall not send, share or transmit malicious information about or that relates to another person through a computer.
The prosecution, led by the Chief State Attorney Richard Bidivu Mbuka, amended the charge sheet from 2 counts to 8, all related to hate speech and defamation. The prosecution said that investigations into the matter are on course and they asked for more time to conclude.
We are not seeking for tomorrow. We are seeking a standover of just 1 hour.
The prosecution seeks an adjournment for a mentioned date, that from that date we shall inform court on the status of the investigation.
Borora's lawyers, led by the president of the Uganda Law Society, Bernard Owundo, asked the court to grant their client bail after they presented all the requirements. However, the prosecution declined their request, asking for time to analyze the surety documents. The court adjourned the hearing to Friday next week for a ruling on the request for bail. It is alleged that Borora shared malicious information about Speaker of Parliament Anita Among between March and June this year via his X account. The Rwanda presidential and parliamentary elections are set to take place from Sunday to Tuesday. In Uganda, the elections shall start at 7 a.m., with 100,000 registered voters expected to participate. The three presidential contestants are Paul Kagame, the current president of Rwanda, Frank Habineza, a member of the Democratic Green Party of Rwanda, and Philippe Mpayimana, an independent. During a press conference at the Rwanda High Commission in Chitande, Kampala, the Rwanda High Commissioner to Uganda, Joseph Rutabana, urged Rwandan citizens to participate in electing their leader.
We have tried to mobilize people from across the country here in Kampala and in rural areas. The numbers of people who have registered have actually surpassed 10,000. That's right. Although they might not all of them be able to make it because, as I mentioned, we have only one polling station, which is here.
He added that there is an arrangement for those who are not registered to also take part.
We'll be having a desk for people who might not fulfill all these qualifications so that we can assess if you identify yourself as a Rwandan citizen but you have not registered with us. We have also an annex where we can put you instead of depriving you from your rights of voting.
President Kagame has ruled Rwanda since 1994. Coming to power in the wake of the genocide of an estimated 800,000 Tutsis and moderate Hutus. This will be the 66-year-old Kagame's fourth official term. U.S. President Joe Biden delivers remarks at the end of the NATO summit held in Washington, where he acknowledges concerns over his mental capacity, saying he's focused on reassuring Democrats amid growing calls for his withdrawal from November's presidential election.
I'm determined on running, but I think it's important that I allay fears by let them see me out there. I'm not having any of my European allies come up to me and say, Joe, don't run. What I hear them say is, you've got to win. Can't let this guy come forward. He'd be a disaster.
NATO leaders pledged enduring support for Ukraine and commitment to their alliance as they wrapped up a 3-day summit overshadowed by doubts over President Joe Biden's fitness to run for crucial power in the United States.
My predecessor has made it clear he has no commitment to NATO. He's made it clear that he would feel no obligation to honor Article 5.
The 32-nation alliance used the Pompfield 75th anniversary gala in the U.S. Capitol to showcase its resolve against Russia 2.5 years into the Kremlin's invasion of its pro-Western neighbor. But the gathering was clouded by uncertainty in the United States as Biden fights for his political survival. The U.S. leader compared his commitment to the transatlantic alliance to comments from his challenger, former President Donald Trump.